Everyone comments on the 27 years he spent in prison and the true grace he had in forgiving those that had ultimately put him in prison in the first place. But even prior to that, his zeal, his commitment, his strategy was extraordinary.
There is room for all the various races in this country. The Africans want one man, one vote. They want political independence.
The lessons and the wisdom from President Mandela, I think, is purpose. And when you look at Mandela and everything that he went through, it's quite remarkable.
I have cherished the idea of a democratic and free society in which all persons will live together in harmony and with equal opportunity. It is an idea for which I hope to live for and to see realized. But my Lord, if it needs be, it is an idea for which I am prepared to die.
I remember I was at my aunt's house, and one of my aunts came out. She was sort of the crazy aunt, and she was dancing and saying, Mandela is free.
I wish to put it plainly that the government has taken a firm decision to release Mr. Mandela unconditionally.
Bring back Nelson Mandela. Bring him back home to Soweto. I want to see him walking down the street.
And that's sort of when I started to hear about people around the world who were doing this sort of stuff. It was really empowering.
The compassion and the forgiveness and the vision, you know, to move forward. It's a wisdom that's unparalleled.
Nelson Hodisasa Mandela, do hereby swear to devote myself to the well-being of the Republic and all its people.
He was that person who would say, oh, excuse me, have you met my guard? Have you actually met my guard? This is Joseph, and he has three children. Like, that kind of level of respect for every human and every person that he crossed paths with.
I have to say, one of the most amazing people I've ever met in my life, of course, is Nelson Mandela. He said the greatest lesson he ever learned was from his childhood. One day he opened the pen to bring the sheep out to pasture, the goats, and he walked ahead of them as a young child, naively thinking that's what a leader does, until he realized the only way to get them from the pen out to the pasture was to go behind them. In fact, a true leader, his exact words, said he leads their flock from behind.
Throughout history, every generation has been called upon to leave a great mark on this planet, and we have the opportunity to do that within our lifetime.
Nelson Mandela, bring him back home.